Hello everyone. I am S. Scott Mishra, Assistant Professor, School of Electronics Engineering. This video tutorial we are going to discuss how you are able to do digital and linear integrated circuit lab using Tinkercad. Now, Tinkercad is a software platform to design various circuits, electronic circuits, and we'll be using this Tinkercad for performing our experiments online, and this platform will be used for our online lab exam as well. So let's begin. First thing first, what is this Tinkercad and how you will be able to design your own circuits and will be able to simulate the same and get the required results. So first we have to know what is Tinkercad. So Tinkercad, we are discussing that it's a software or it's a platform where we can easily design circuits. And in this very case, we are discussing about digital circuits to be precise. And then later on, we can think about analog circuit implementation. So first thing first, that is your digital circuits. So how to design your own circuit, how to simulate, how to get the results. So all those things are part of our discussion. So in this video tutorial, I am going to walk through all different aspects of this Tinkercad and how you are able to design your experiments and verify the output through simulation. So first I will see how will be the control panel, how will be the environment, so that you will be practicing on the same and you will be comfortable while doing the laboratory exam. So we'll do some Tinkercad hands-on, and for that, first thing is this Tinkercad is not a installable software, rather it's on a cloud platform where you can simply log into the website or the web portal of Tinkercad and start doing your experiments. You can start designing your circuits and simulate the same. So you don't have to install any software for this. It will be on cloud and you just have to log in. So for that you have to create an account. So it's free. That's a good news. It's free. You don't have to pay anything for the license. And it is hassle free. You can create an account in tinkercad.com and you can start doing experiments. So first thing is that, as you are well aware, that our digital electronic circuit part is broadly of two different types. One is your combinational circuit and another one is your sequential circuit. In combinational circuit, basically we design circuits using logic gates. So we do not have any clock, or the output do not require any clock. Whereas the second type of circuit is a sequential circuit. In sequential circuit, we definitely require a clock and it depends upon the time. So we can design both the combinational circuit as well as the sequential circuit using this Tinkercad tool. So we'll go one by one. In this first video lecture, I will discuss mostly broadly on the Tinkercad platform and how to get familiarize with Tinkercad so that you can be comfortable working on Tinkercad, and then later on we can discuss on how to design a combinational circuit, how to design a sequential circuit using the Tinkercad tool. So first thing, in Tinkercad, as we are discussing, we can simply log into tinkercad.com. Then if you are a new user, in most of the cases, in your case, you all are new users. So you have to sign up. And once you have already signed up, and once you are already a user, then from the next time onwards, you don't have to sign up, you just have to log in. And this Tinkercad.com platform is very, very user friendly. So very easy. And you do, I think you don't have, you won't be having any problem in getting used to this particular software. So side by side, I will show you how to create an account in Tinkercad, how to sign up, and in the later cases, login, and how to start building your own projects, or how to start building your own circuits, and how to test it. So as you can see on the slide, it's a diagram, or it's a screenshot rather, is given that you can, this will be a screen of your Tinkercad. There after you log in, then you can go to the circuits. This is the circuit tab. First you have to go to the circuits because we are designing circuits, and this Tinkercad is also used for different three-dimensional design. So let's forget about it. That is not part of our focus here. We are focusing on circuit design. So you have to go to circuits, and then we have to go to this create new circuit. So this first thing is circuits, then you have to go to new circuit. So after clicking this, it will open a new window, or it will open a new panel there. You can put different components and you can create your own circuits. So let's directly do the hands-on. So first thing, I have to go to any particular web browser. In your case, I'm using a Firefox, Mozilla Firefox. You can use any standard browser for it. There is no limitation. So you can go for Chrome, you can go for Internet Explorer, or any of the browser of your choice. So I am going to this Mozilla Firefox browser. So here there are two options. You can directly type the address, that is tinkercad.com, or simply you can search also in case Tinkercad. So I'm searching Tinkercad on Google. So it will give me the link. So this first link that I'm getting is the tinkercad.com. So I'll go into the tinkercad.com. Okay, so it's loading. Well, so this is the screen of the tinkercad.com. So tinkercad.com, here you can see some options which are available. You can see sign in and join now. So I will consider you all are new users, so you will definitely prefer to join now. So I'm going for join now. Now there are different options. You can be an educator, or you can be a student. So in case you are a student, you can join a class. Your educator or your tutor or your professor will share with you a class code. In that case, you can join a class using that code, which will be shared by your professor. In case you want to create a personal account for practice purpose, you can go for a personal account. So first I will let you go through this personal account. So here you can create a personal account. Then later on, when we are doing that laboratory experiment, that time I will tell you how to join the class. So for the time being, you have to practice the circuit. So you have to create your own account and do your own practice, so that whenever we are conducting the lab exam, you can join the class. And I will tell you later how you are going to join a class and how you are going to perform your experiments and how you will be evaluated. So first thing is create a personal account here. Now there are different options this Tinkercad is giving us. Sign up with email, sign in with Google. So you don't have to create any account. You simply sign in with your Google account, existing Google account. Your Kit account is also given by Google. So you can simply use your Kit mail and password. That will also do. So sign in with Google. So it will take me to the Google login. So I have some account, so I can just simply log into this account giving the password. Don't save. Now it's loading. Okay, so I got a welcome message. I got a welcome message. So I just want to cross it. Now you can see this is the panel. This is the panel of your Tinkercad, where you have to focus on the left side panel first. So here I told you first you have to go to circuits. Okay. Now there are some tutorials. You can go for the Tinkercad circuit, Tinkercad try circuits, or in our case we'll directly go to our digital circuits. So I will go for create new circuit. Okay, great. So now, as you can see, my complete panel is ready. So as you can see, there are some customizing options here. There are some control panels here, like code, start simulation, exports here, and all those things. And most important thing is components, because if you want to build a circuit, you require some components. So this is our component panel, where I can simply drag and drop some of the components and I can start designing the circuits. So in the first basic tutorial, I would demonstrate how you simply create a verification of a simple logic gate. So that is a simple circuit that I just require a particular gate IC, and I will test it whether it is giving me the required output of the according to the truth table. So you just click here, components, basic, you change it to all. The most important thing I'm telling, again, I'm telling, repeating the same thing. In the component, by default, it is basic, you change it to all. Now you scroll down to this particular component panel. And first thing I require is a breadboard. So I have different type of breadboard, regular breadboard or a small breadboard or a mini breadboard. So in just for example, I'll take a regular breadboard, the same breadboard that you use in your lab. So I just dragged it. So this breadboard, I just dragged it to my main canvas. So this is the area where you are going to design the circuit. In this area, I'm going to drag down this particular breadboard. Okay. So now, as you already know, the breadboard connection, all these things are connected together, and in the horizontal line, these lines are connected together. I think you are very much familiar with the breadboard configuration. So I don't have to tell you how the breadboards are internally connected. So I think you have that prior idea about breadboard. So one important thing we are going to do here is for any circuit, we require a power supply. That is very important thing. You require a power supply. And in this digital circuit, we require two important things. One is your input, one is your output. So input we are going to give through switches, and output we are going to verify through LEDs. So most important thing, I require a power supply, I require switches to give input, and I require LED to get output. So first I will go for the power supply. So what is the power supply options that I am having in this component panel? So first, let me see, we have a battery, we have different type of batteries, but let me go to a standard power supply. As you can see here, multimeter is there, power supply is there, function generator is there, oscilloscope is there. So I will go for a regular power supply. So I'll just simply drag and drop here. Okay, so let me adjust the size. So you can just use the mouse to adjust the size of this particular screen. So this is the power supply, this is the breadboard. So as you can see, red is your plus 5 and this is your 0. You can adjust this power supply. So if you click on the power supply, it will give you what is the voltage, what is the current, and what is the name. So this is the, this is how you are going to define what will be the voltage rating of the particular power supply and what will be the current rating and what will be the name. So this is just a configuration of this particular power supply. So for digital experiment, we require 5 volt. So 5 volt is there by default. So this is it. So power supply is ready. Now I require to give some digital input to my gate. So for that, I require a switch. That switch will actually toggle between 0 and 1, as you are well aware about it. So I will use some switch. So what type of switch I am using? Just have a note here. So there are different types of switches here. So I will select a very logical one. So I will go for the slide switch. Okay. So I'll tell you why I am choosing the slide switch. As you can see, this is called the common terminal, and this is one terminal X, another terminal Y. So if the switch is in left side of the left side is the this particular lever, then you can get this connected to this. When it will slide to the right side, then this right connector will be connected to the common. So this is the configuration. So why we are going for this? Because it is very convenient option to switch between 1 and 0. So I'll show you how I am switching between 1 and 0. So let me drag some 2 switches. Why do I require 2 switches? Because I require A and B, 2 inputs for a logic gate. So I dragged 1 switch. Similarly, I will drag the second switch. So I have dragged 2 switches. So what I want here is that this particular switch need to be connected to plus 5 one side and 0 volt another side. So when the switch will be left side, it will be giving your plus 5. When it will be connected to the right side, it will be giving 0. So this is the best method to toggle between 0 and 1 for giving input to the digital IC so that you can get the output. So I think you got my point here, that what is the need of this switch? This switch is nothing but controlling your inputs 0 and 1. Okay. So first thing is that I will consider the lower one as VCC. So I will just click on this red and I'll just drag it. I'll drag it to plus 5. That means this complete row is now my plus 5 volt. Now the second also I will do the same. I will connect it to the second row. Now this is my 0 volt. This upper line is my 0 volt. Now for convenient student, I will do one important thing here. As you can see, I will just place this for little better visual. Okay, now you can see that the red color is my plus 5. So I will change the color to, let's say, red, and this one preferably black, because black is for 0 volt and red is full up for 5 volt. So this is color coding is also important, because once you are doing this circuit, you will sometimes get confused that which one is plus 5, which one is 0. So that kind of confusion should be avoided. For that reason, color coding I am telling you from the beginning, so that while designing a complicated circuit, you don't get confused which where is what. So students, it's a good practice you keep the color coding always, so that you will not be confused while designing a complicated circuit where many wires are there, many components are there, so that you don't get messed up in the process. So that's why I'm going for color coding. So red is for 5 volt and black is for 0 volt, ground. Okay. So same connection I have to give to these switches. So let's say I want this particular point as 0, this particular point as 1. So what I will do, I will take from any point to this point. And I will color code it to black. So this is my ground, and the other side from this to here, and color code it to red. So that means my this side is my 0 volt and this side is my 5 volt. Same thing I'll do for the second switch. Color code it to black. Red. Okay, fine. So my switches are ready for taking the inputs. Now, if I take from the center point, if I take output from the center point, so depending upon the toggling of this switch, I can toggle the input from 0 or 1. Very simple. Okay. Now, I am going to test a AND gate for an instant. So everybody know a AND gate is a IC7408. So let me go back to the slide so that you will have an understanding. So we are discussing that how to create a account, how to create a circuit, how to go to create a new circuit, and how to use different components to start designing the circuit. So we are discussing a test bed. So whatever we are doing now on the Tinkercad, on the website, the same thing is called a test bed. Test bed means you are testing the circuit. And later on, I am going to tell you how to simulate the same. So what we are doing now in the Tinkercad is the simplest gate verification circuit. That means I will go for a simple IC 7408 for an instant AND gate, and I'll check whether the AND gate is performing right or not using the truth table verification. So few things we have to keep it in mind, as I have already shown. First thing is the power supply. You have to select the proper power supply. Then definitely for connection, you require a breadboard. So we have taken a breadboard already. We require some components like IC. As we are discussing that 7408, that is AND gate, is we are going to verify the truth table of AND gate. So we are going to select some of the ICs. So one important thing is simply drag for wire or interconnection. As I have shown you already that how you are going to interconnect different terminals, for that you require just simply drag it, so it will create a wire. And I have already told you also how to color code it and why the color coding is very important whenever you are designing a very big or complicated circuit, so that you don't mess up with the connection. So color coding is also very important for the wire, so that you don't get confused whenever you are going for multiple ICs or multiple connections where there is a fair chance that you'll get confused. So student, it's a very good practice to always do interconnection and color code it. And most of the time the 0 is black color, the VCC is red color. In case of any input, you can use yellow color. In case of any output, you can go for green color. So you can have a better organization of the circuit so that you don't get confused while going for a bigger circuit or complicated circuit. So one important thing that I'm already discussing, that how to give digital inputs to the circuit. So already the answer is switch. So we are using a switch to give inputs. So we create our own input panel in this case. So how you are creating the own input panel using the switch? Just now I have created two switch and connected it to plus 5 and 0 so that I can toggle between 0 and 5, and that can work like a digital input to our circuit. And then how we are going to get the digital output? That is through LEDs. So definitely we have to create a LED, and that LED will test our output. So in this simple case of gate verification, I require one output. So I require only one LED. Now, very important point, student, whenever you are creating a LED circuit or output circuit, then that time you have to take care of one important thing, that this LED cannot be directly connected to 5 volt. Otherwise, you are going to damage that LED. So simply you have to put a resistor. So that resistor you have to put in series with the LED, so that it will not get damaged. So for this simple circuitry, LED plus resistor is our digital output. So digital output circuit, whenever you are designing, you have to take LED and you have to take resistor. So now I think you have a fair amount of understanding that how to create your own input panel, that is through switches, and how to create your own output panel, that is through LED and resistor. Okay, so this will discuss after I'll finish that simple experiment, because this is later on we are going to focus how we are going to do all the experiments in digital electronics, that is for combination circuits and sequential circuits. So we'll come to this slide later. Let's go back to our Tinkercad. So this is the Tinkercad that we have left. So now I require output. So as you can see, this is the component panel. In the component panel, I have to select the LED. So as you can see here, this is the LED. Output LED. So I will drag it. Okay. Now I can select the color. So for this instance, I am going for a green LED. Okay. Now, see one important thing here. Now, if you just put the mouse over the terminal, you can see whether it is a cathode or an anode. So always you see the right side is the anode and the left side is the cathode. So the anode, I have to put a resistor. So I have to go to the component panel again and I have to select a resistor. So resistor I have selected, I am dragging it and I'm going to put a resistor here. Okay. Now it is asking for what is the resistance value, 1K by default. So I don't have any issue in 1K. So I'm going for 1K and this is my output circuit, as you can see. So this should be connected, the cathode should be connected to the ground. So I will simply take from here and I will connect it to ground line. So this is my ground line. Okay. And I will color code it to black because this is my ground line. So this is my cathode and this is my anode. So this anode means I have to give output to this particular resistor. So we are discussing that we are going to test a regular IC, that is your 74084 for an instant. So for that you have to go to the component panel. In the component panel, I have to search for IC. Okay, now you can see logic. So logic has started, logic family. So here you can see different type of ICs are there. So I am going for a simply one simple. Okay, so this is a AND gate, 7408. So I'll drag this IC, and always remember, whenever you are placing the IC, it should be between the two separate. Otherwise, if you put it like this, then it will be all shorted. As you know, this is interconnected. So I have to put the IC in middle. Okay, I think you know about this concept. So I have placed. So you require pin configuration. So I'll show you pin configuration. So this is the pin configuration of logic gates. So I am going for this AND gate. As you already know, you have done it in your lab, that 1 and 2 is my input and 3 is my output for the first AND gate. So I'm just going to test 1 AND gate, 1, 2 input, 3 is output. And you already know VCC is 14 and ground is 7. So based on this pin diagram, I have to design the circuit. So I require 7. So this is my 7. This is ground. So I will take one wire and connect it to the ground line. So this is my ground line. This whole line is my ground line. So I can put it here also. Color coded to black. And I require a VCC. So from here, I'm going to connect to the VCC line. So this is my VCC line. And I'll color code it to red. So now you see the IC power supply has been given. That means 7th pin is ground and your 14th pin is your VCC. Now I'm going to check the AND gate. So I require 2 inputs from this switch. So from the center point, common point I have to take. So I will consider this as A and this as B. So I'm writing it. So as you can see, there is a annotation tool here. So I can write simply what I have to write here. So this variable I have to take as A. So this switch is my A. And I will take another annotation tool here. And I will write B here. I'll write B. So this is for understanding. So this switch is for giving A input and this switch is for giving B input. Okay. So let me take connection from the common. So this is my A. So A should go to 1. So I told you, you color code this to yellow input and this common will go into second pin. Pin number 2. Okay. I'll color code it to yellow. So these are the inputs from the common point I am taking from pin number 1 and pin number 2. That means what? That means I'm connecting 1 and 2. So 1 is A, 2 is B. And then finally output will come from 3. So from 3, third pin, I have to take and connect it to the LED through the register. Remember this, through the register. And I told you, take another color wire. So in this case, I am taking a pink wire. So this pink wire is output, which is coming from the IC and it is given to the LED. So that based on this input, this LED can change its state. Okay. So almost we are done with the circuit. Let us simulate. So this is simple AND gate verification circuit. So this part is my input panel. This part is my output panel and this is my logic gate. So I can simply start simulating it. So as you can see, here is the power supply. Okay. So let's start the simulation. So for starting the simulation, you have a button here in the control panel. It's called start simulation. So you can simply click on start simulation. So as you have started the simulation, you might be noticing here there is a clock running that is called simulator time. That means how much time it has been elapsed after the simulation has been started. So you can see what is the voltage and what is the real time current that you are getting from the power supply, and the power supply is working fine and you are getting all the. So as you can see here, everybody know what is an AND gate. AND gate output will be 0, 0, output will be 0, 0, 1, output will be 0, 1, 0, output will be 0, and 1, 1, output will be 1. So as you can see here, this is my 0 because my switch is towards the 0. And if I want 0, 1, so this input is my 0, 0 input and my output is 0. The LED is not glowing. So first thing, I will go for the second condition of truth table, 0, 1. So this I have to toggle. Okay. So now I have toggled here. That means this is 0, 1. So 0, 1, the output is still 0. Now I require 1, 0. So this will be 0 and this will be 1. So 1, 0 output is again 0. And the last one is 1, 1. So I'll take 1, 1. And the LED glows. That means your AND gate is working fine. So this is the verification of a simple gate. So we can the same. So I think I made it very simple for you guys to create a simple circuit using the IC and how to create the input panel and how to get the output panel using LED and register. And you can simply create any combination circuit using this concept. So as I'm writing, so I can go for simple annotation tool here for, let's say, another annotation tool I'm using. For that, I need to stop the simulation first. So let me stop the simulation and use the annotation tool. This annotation tool I'm going to use for output. Okay, so I can write something here. y. So y is my output. Y. Okay. So we have just now tested AND gate. So we are done with the AND gate. Now simply I'll take this IC out and I will put any other IC to test whether other gates are also working fine according to our design or not. So I'll simply take this IC out now and I'll put a XOR gate. So everybody know, I think everybody know what is the XOR gate IC number, that is 7486. So I will take this IC out. I will take this IC out and simply press delete this particular IC. I don't want anymore. So I deleted it. And instead of that, I'm going to put a 7486 in the same line. You have to understand this. You have to put it into the same line. So I'm putting it into the same line. Otherwise the connections will be all messed up. So you can see, this is your pin number one, this is your pin number two, and this is your pin number three. So one and two are input and three is the output. And this is your 14 pin, which is VCC. And this is your 7 pin, which is ground. So now I'm going to check the XOR gate. So I think students, you are very much familiar with the truth table of XOR gate, that is A, B and Y. So if I take A0, B0, output will be 0. A0, B1, output is 1. A1, B0, output is 1. A1, B1, output should be 0. So I think you are very much familiar with this truth table. So let's simulate. So start simulation here. Okay. So now you can see both the inputs A and B are 0. So the output is 0 as expected. Next, I will take 0, 1. So this is 0, 1. So output is green. That means 1. So 0, 1 output is 1. Now I will make it 1, 0. So 1, 0. So you can see 1, 0. Output is 1. Again, I will make 1, 1. So 1, 1. So 1, 1. Output is 0. That means our XOR gate is working perfectly. So similarly, I have shown you two examples of one AND gate, one XOR gate, and you can take any of the logic gate and you can refer this logic gate IC diagram. That means what is the pin configuration, which one is input, which one is output, so which is there in the data sheet. And you can refer this data sheet and you can do the connection according to the data sheet pin number so that you can go for the particular connection and you can verify any logic gate. So student, I think this is our first experiment in your lab, the DNLIC lab, that verification of logic gate is our first experiment. So you can very well do the simulation, connection and all the circuit building work on this Tinkercad, and you can simply design any circuit and verify it using simulation. So for that you require this IC pin configuration diagram, and obviously you have to pre-design your circuits. The circuit diagram should be already available to you. You must have designed it and then you can implement the same using the Tinkercad tool. So this is a simple circuit that we have designed. So let me stop this simulation. So I have stopped the simulation. Okay. So now let me go back to the slide where I have left. So you are familiar with how to get started with Tinkercad. I think you're very much familiar with how to start connections and how to build the circuit. So now we'll look from our digital circuit perspective. So what is digital electronic circuit and how different experiments have been performed using digital electronic circuit? So first thing is, it is divided into two types. One is combinational circuit and second one is your sequential circuit. So in the combinational circuit part, you have just now I have done this experiment, logic gates. So you can verify the logic gate. So I have done it for AND gate and XOR gate. You can simply do it for OR, NOT and NAND, and it's just replacing the IC and you can verify the different logic gates. So apart from this logic gates in combination circuit, you can have some application specific ICs, or you can design your different combination circuits like half adder, full adder, parallel adder. So even your decoder, multiplexer using simple IC or simple logic gates. So that is also an option. You can do that. And there are some application specific predefined ICs also, like 4-bit parallel adder is a IC. So decoder, 2-to-4 line decoder. So that is also a IC. And multiplexer, 2x1 multiplexer, that is also a IC. So those are all different application specific ICs for combinational circuits. So all these experiments are there, part of our DNLIC lab. So first thing is that I will tell you in this video lecture how to design a simple half adder, or how to design a simple full adder, or even for an instant, I think you must be remembering, in the first experiment of our DNLIC lab, we have a circuit called XOR gate implementation using NAND gate. So for that XOR gate implementation using NAND gate, we have a circuit for that. And we can simply implement that circuit and check whether our circuit is working fine according to the XOR truth table. So that is also possible. So all the circuits that we have done in our DNLIC lab can be implemented using this Tinkercad. That is my point. So that is whatever we are discussing here right now is about combinational circuit. Now the same thing can be done for sequential circuit using flip-flops. So you're well aware about flip-flops. So in our lab perspective, we have two different types of flip-flop that we use in our lab. That is your JK flip-flop and D flip-flop. And I think I have color-coded it here. D flip-flop is mostly used for shift register, because shift register option require a D flip-flop, which is shifting off operation that you know already. Characteristic equation of D flip-flop is Q of T plus 1 is equal to Q of T. That means whatever we give as input, the same thing I will get as output after application of clock. So it's basically a delay flip-flop or D flip-flop. So IC 7474 is a D flip-flop, and we generally use it for shift register kind of application. Now, when I am going for a sequential circuit for designing any counter, so in that case, I will prefer a JK flip-flop. That JK flip-flop is IC 7473. So JK flip-flop will be most preferable for counter design, because most of the time, if you are going for a synchronous counter or an asynchronous counter, you prefer JK flip-flop, because straightforward, it will give you a design with much simplicity. That means you don't have to convert that flip-flop into any other flip-flop. Because if you're going for a D flip-flop, then you have to take it into a toggle mode. For that, you have to take the Q bar output to the input. So for that case, we are not going to complicate that circuit. So very simple thing, that you require a toggle operation for asynchronous counters. So for that toggle operation, J and K value should be 1. So I'm sure you are well aware about all the theoretical concept. And I have already told you that in the laboratory session also, for some student for whom I am taking the lab. So this asynchronous counter and synchronous counter, both can be derived from a simple JK flip-flop. That is your IC 7473. So if you have the data sheet or pin configuration of JK flip-flop and D flip-flop, so it's just a matter of time that you are going to design a circuit using this Tinkercad, and you just connect it the same way you connect it in physically in the lab, the same thing that you have to do on the software. Okay. I think I made myself quite clear about the concept that we are going to do. So student, the most important thing is that what we are doing physically in the lab, we are going to replicate the same thing in a software environment, nothing else. In the lab environment, you are holding all those physical components and putting it to the breadboard and doing all the connection and check the verification of the circuit. The same thing we are doing here, but in a logical manner, not in a physical manner. Everything we are putting in the software, and the software is doing the job for us. It is actually simulating and showing the results. So I think you're familiar now. So let's move on. So these are the circuit experiments that we have in our DNLIC lab. So let me go through it quickly. The first experiment is about verification of logic gates, and there are two design problems. One is design and simulation of AND or NOT gate using NAND gate. So NAND gate is a universal gate. Using NAND gate, you can go for AND or NOT, and you can also go for XOR. So that XOR is little bigger circuit, and AND or NOT are very simple circuit. I have done it in your lab, so I think you must be having an understanding about all this. So only one thing is that Verilog. Okay, so right now, student, just understand one thing, you just forget about Verilog now. So that Verilog is for you require that Xilinx, and Xilinx, you we generally did our simulation experiments on Xilinx design suite. So that Xilinx design suite is a software. The cloud version is we are not comfortable yet. That installation file is huge, and I don't know how many of you already have it in your laptop. So at this point of time, we are not discussing about Verilog, because Verilog, if at all you have Verilog, you already know how to simulate circuit in Verilog. So that's nothing new for you. You already know about it. Only thing is that this Tinkercad is new to you, and how to physically do all the experiments, all the hardware experiments, that is the point of discussion here. So the second experiment is about full adder. Full adder implementation and 2-bit parallel binary adder and 2-bit parallel binary adder using 7483 IC. So these are all you have done in the lab. So all those ICs are available in this Tinkercad. You just have to know the pin number, and you just have to connect it and get the output verified. And the third experiment is about decoder, that is 2-line to 4-line decoder, and then hardware implementation. So simulation, as I have already told, you already know Verilog program. I have already told you in lab how to do Verilog programs, how to write Verilog programs, how to test Verilog programs. So this is basically how those hardware experiments should be done using Tinkercad. So 2-to-4-line decoder using NAND gate, you can design for active low. For active high, you can go for AND gate. So then you have multiplexer. So in multiplexer, 2+1 multiplexer is the simplest form. So simply NAND gate you can use, and you can implement a 2+1 multiplexer. Hardware implementation of 2+1 multiplexer using NAND gate. So NAND gate IC is available in Tinkercad. You just have to know the pin numbers, and you already have the circuit diagram. So you just connect it and you can get the multiplexer done. So these are the combination circuit that we performed in our DNLIC lab. Now these are the sequential circuit that you have done. That is, first is your flip-flop. So we simulate different flip-flop, and we check the output of truth table of all the flip-flops. So all the flip-flop ICs are available, mostly the JK and D1. So this IC7473 and IC7474. That is JK and D respectively. So those ICs are also available in our Tinkercad, and you can simulate the JK and D flip-flop and check the truth table of both the flip-flops. Then we have design problem here. In the design problem, we have shift register, that is your serial input, serial output, CISO. So you have serial input, serial output, CISO, and you have hardware implementation of the same serial input using D flip-flop. Then the last or fifth digital experiment that you are having in your DNLIC lab is the counter. So in this, we have a 2-bit synchronous counter using JK flip-flop, and you have hardware implementation of the same. So that hardware implementation you are going to do in Tinkercad. And this design and simulation of 2-bit asynchronous counter. So you have a 2-bit synchronous counter, and you have a 2-bit asynchronous counter for your DNLIC. So first we are discussing about combination circuit. So I have given you a brief overview what we have already done in DNNIC lab in our laboratory, and the same thing we are going to do on Tinkercad in the online. So in the software environment, the cloud environment, in the online environment for our online lab needs. So first thing we are going to discuss here, combination circuit. In the combination circuit, as you are very much aware, that n number of input lines are there, n number of output lines are there, and a combination circuit will be comprising of gates, basic gates. So this is a simple example how a combination circuit will look like. This combination circuit is comprising of OR gate and AND gate, and we are getting output. So different circuits are there in combination circuit. Now scope, one is your logic gates, IC, adder, decoder, multiplexers. So these are part of your syllabus in your DNLICL. So these are the IC pin numbers for your convenience. So any circuit you can design, if you just refer this data sheet. So all your combination circuit design is based on different gates, right? So these are some of the gate: AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, and XOR gate. So these are the five type of gates more basically we are going to use to implement any circuit in our DNLIC lab. So you have to take it as a reference while designing any circuits. So this is your logic gates. So circuit one. So in this circuit one, today I'm going to show you how to design this circuit one, that is your XOR gate using NAND gate, that is IC7400. So this XOR gate using NAND gate, just a example I'm giving. This is just an example I'm giving. So as you can see here, how many gates are there? There are four gates. So four gates and all are NAND gate. That means which IC is required? IC7400 is required. So four and NAND gates are there means how many ICs are required? Only one IC is required, because you already know inside a NAND gate IC7400 there are four NAND gates present. You can see the previous slide. As you can see, this is the NAND gate IC7400. How many NAND gates are there? One, two, three, four. Four NAND gate IC, no, four NAND gates are already present inside a single IC7400. So what we are going to do here, I am going to consider only one NAND gate IC to implement this circuit. Now, for your convenience, based on this data sheet, based on this particular data sheet, I have already marked the pin numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 8, 12, 13, 11. So already according to the IC pin diagram, I have marked the number of pin. So based on this pin configuration, I am simply going to do the connection. So this circuit we are going to implement in Tinkercad. Okay, let's see how we are doing it. And what is this whole circuit? This whole circuit will work like a XOR gate. Now the whole circuit should work like a XOR gate, and it should satisfy our truth table. So what is the truth table? A, B, A XOR B. So you are already familiar. I have already shown you in Tinkercad. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. The output should be 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, and 1, 1, 0. So we are going to implement the same circuit in Tinkercad, and we are going to verify whether that whole circuit is working like a XOR gate or that we are going to simulate in Tinkercad. So let's begin. So which IC I require? I require 7400. And what connection I require? I require these connections according to this circuit diagram. Okay. So I'm going to Tinkercad. Okay. So what I require? One output is there. Two inputs are there, A and B. That is same. Only thing is that the connection to this IC will change. So I will replace this IC, and I replace these wires also, A and B, because I will do fresh according to the requirement. I'll take it out. Okay. Now what gate I require? I require a 7400 NAND gate. So this is my NAND gate. I'm placing exactly the same place where it should be. So this NAND gate should be placed here. Because why? Do you understand why I am placing it here? Because this is seventh pin should be grounded, and this 14 pin should be VCC. Okay, so this 7400 IC is placed in the right position. Okay, so I have two inputs A and B, and I have one output, that is this Y. Okay, so what is the connection diagram requires? The connection diagram, A and B should be connected to 1 and 2. So A should be connected to 1. And I told you, you color code it. So A should be connected yellow, and B also required to be connected to second pin. So I will make it yellow. Okay. So A and B are connected. So according to my diagram, A is connected to 1 and B is connected to 2. Okay. So now, so according to diagram, I have to connect 3 should be connected to 5 and 9. Okay. So 3 output should be connected to 5 and 9. So 3 should be connected to, so this is my 5. Okay. I'll color code it to something like purple. 3 should be connected to 5, and also 3 should be connected to 9. So where is 9? This is my 7, 8, 9. Okay. And this should be your purple. So 3 is connected to 5 and 9. Now, next, what I require? I require A also connected to 4. And B also connected to 10. So indirectly I'm telling 1 should be connected to 4 and 2 should be connected to 10. So 1 should be connected to 4. So this is 1. It should be connected to 4. 1 should be connected to 4, and I'll give you another color so that there will be no confusion. 1 should be connected to 4 and 2 should be connected to 10. So 2 should be connected to 10. So this is my 8, 9, 10. And color code it together. So I have done this connection. So this connection, this part is all over. Now I require 6 should be connected to 12 and 8 should be connected to 13. So 6 should be connected to 12 and 8 to 13. So this 6 should be connected to 12. So 12 means 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Here. So I'll color code it to something else, and eight to 13. So 8 means this 8 to 13. This also I'll color code it to orange. Okay. Now my required connections are done. 6, 12, 8, 13. Then where I will get the output? I will get the output at 11. So I'll take, this is my 11. From here, I am going to take to the output of that. Okay, so output is green. So I have done all connections. According to my circuit diagram, I have done all connections. So let's simulate. You know where to simulate. This is the control panel. I can start simulation. Okay. So the simulation has been started. So you can see 0, 0, right? This is 0, this is 0. A 0, B 0. What is the output? 0. You can verify. A 0, B 0. Output 0. Next, 0, 1. So 0, 1 LED glow. That means 1. Output is 1. So 0, 1. A0, B1. Output is 1. So A0, B1. Output is 1. Next, I will go to the next condition. A1, B0. Output is 1. So you can see A1, B0. Output is 1. And what is the last condition? A1, B1. Output is 0. So you can take it out. A1, B1. Output is 0 because the LED is off. So just now we have implemented this XOR gate using NAND gate, using IC7400, and all connections we have done according to the requirement, and we have checked it is working like XOR gate according to the picture. So student, we have seen many different aspects of this Tinkercad tool, and we have seen how to design combination circuit using Tinkercad. So in the next video lecture, I will go into detail about two more circuits. In the next coming video lectures, I am going to tell you how to design second circuit and third circuit. So in that case, we are going to design a half adder and full adder. Till then, I am signing off from this video lecture, and we'll see the next circuits and sequential circuit in the next videos. Okay, so thank you.